Hey everyone, it's Ian from Aussie Tech again. And today I'm talking about something that everyone's always talking about, vlog cameras, and everyone's raving on about the new RX 100 Mark 7. It's great, you know. It's got a good zoom, it's got microphone input and all that stuff. It's probably as good, and it's small and light. That's what everyone loves, a small and light. Now there's something that's a little bit bigger than that, or should I say, different shaped. But I actually think it's these are the most underrated cameras for vlogging. Everyone's talking about RX100s and the G7X Mark III, I think it is. But I think Handycams are the most underrated cameras for vlogging. Now, this is the Panasonic VX1. I really like this. I use this a lot for my B-roll. It's small, handy. It's got a really good 32x zoom, which I've shown in another video. It's got a flippy screen that can go around and do all that stuff. It's got a nice wide angle. Now, some of the earlier model Handycams didn't have a very good wide angle. Now this has got a perfect wide angle, so I can hold it out and get myself in footage perfectly. It's got a good quality mic here. But also, I've just started recording. It has another thing that's very important, of course. It has a microphone input. Yay! It's already beating some of those cameras that people use for vlogging. But what's even better about it has a microphone output. So I can put a headphone on if I want to and double check everything. It's touchscreen. Yeah, this is all nice and touchscreen. Everything about this camera is perfect. It's small and light. It's got a good size battery that lasts at least about 2 hours. When I got this, it comes with two batteries, which is incredible. It's got a nice handle, zoom. It can take 20 megapixel photos as well. And really, I really don't understand. I know, yes, in some ways, you know, those little small cameras is good, but you can carry this around quite easily. And people look at you with this and they just think you're just a normal tourist. So they don't think twice about it. But again, look at that. It's just, it's good. I reckon these Handycams, and they'll Sony do some very equivalent ones, and so the Canon and stuff, I think they are the most underrated camera system for vlogging. So I'm going to take this out now and we'll check out this little thing. And what I love about it, of course, on top, I forgot to show hot shoe mount. So I use my wireless Go. I can put that on here, get perfect audio, but even the audio from the camera itself, the surround sound audio, 5.1 surround sound, is really good and reliable if you just use it. But even better when you use it with the wireless Go, and you can put other mics on there as well. So really, it's everything you need in a camera without having to add anything. You've got a big zoom, you've got IBIS, it's got pretty good stabilization, not brilliant, but has got some stabilization. It's small, it's really light. Shouldn't really duplicate. Woo! So yeah, I really think they're the most underrated camera systems for vlogging. So let's go and check it out.
Always look cool with sunglasses. Though you can see the camera in the reflection, can't you? Anyway, so this is now with the VX1. I've come to a nice little area here at Wellington Point, this nice little bridge, and I'm just going to test it out here a little bit. Then we might go to Wellington Point. So let's see how it's coming. And as you can see now, I've got the wireless Go connected for audio. Let's get some sun in my face. So here we are. It's a nice little bridge over here. Nice wonky point, and we'll get some footage of this area and the ducks. work. This is handheld walking stabilization with the VX1, and again, Handycams, they're much more reliable for focus. This thing's actually not too bad in low light, so yeah, and it's nice. And now walking out on this bridge, and I'll show you all the ducks. So what do you think? I think this actually works really well as a vlog camera. You can just carry this one camera around. You can basically get every kind of footage you need. You get nice wide angles. You can zoom in. You can talk to the camera and see yourself. You can get quality audio. So really, there's nothing you can do wrong with this thing. So definitely check it out. Now I'm going to go to Wellington Point now, see if I can get some footage from there. Now I'm coming to you without the Wireless Go, and I'm now here at Raby Bay. I didn't go to Wellington Point because it was packed. I mean, there wasn't even a car park free. So I've come here to a nice little place here in Ormiston on the corner, basically on the edge of Raby Bay, and we'll get some little bit of footage here. What do you reckon? And from here onwards, I won't be using the radio mic. It's just the mic that comes with the camera. So if it's a bit windy, you may hear that. So first test with a bit of wind. Can you hear me? It's supposed to have some wind redirection, so. And also, I wonder if I'm going to get attacked by the plovers, because there's a couple of plovers around here, especially when they've got babies. Man, they come and they will attack you. So we'll see on that as well. Hope not. Thank you. In today's vlog, I did record a bit outside, but without a proper microphone, you pick up way too much wind noise. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I really think this is a brilliant camera for vlogging. What I saw from the footage came out really well, so I'm happy with that. So don't forget, guys, comment down below what you think, and thanks for watching. This is Aussie Tech, where we talk everything tech, but mostly cameras.